Davis Show. I'm Mary Joan. America's favorite comedy show. Starring America's queen of comedy, Joan Davis, as Mrs. Joan Stevens. And featuring Jim Backus as Judge Bradley Stevens.
By Mary John.
Oh, Bobo, a slaughter! Oh, would you like to make a little wager?
Okay, I'll bet you my imitation alligator purse against your imitation cashmere sweater.
I knew that dynamite was a bum.
Yeah, but who'd ever figure that Bobo would knock him out? I know what happened. He threw the fight.
Oh, what's the matter, Joni? Don't you want to pay off your bet?
Oh, yeah, that's it. She's just trying to welt. She doesn't want to give me that alligator purse she bet.
Oh, that's not it. It's just that I bet on a prize fight, not a diving contest. You're a boxing commissioner. Aren't you going to do something about that phony fight?
I certainly am. I'm going to have a little talk with Dynamite tomorrow. And if he doesn't have a satisfactory explanation, I'm going to hold up his purse.
Oh, well, there's just one thing I'd like to know, Joni. Are you going to pay off that bet you made with me?
Not yet. If Brad can hold up Dynamite's purse, I can hold up yours.
Now, remember, Joan, let me talk to Dynamite in my own way.
Oh, don't mind me, Brad. I'm just here to protect my interests.
And I'm here to protect mine.
And I'm just here on my lunch hour.
They must be here. Will you send them in, Miss Bromley? Now remember, I'll do all the talking.
Okay, Brad.
Hi, Mr. Commissioner. Hello. I'm Sophie Fenton. This here is my boy, the next heavyweight champion, Dynamite Tucker.
Hello, how do you do? This is Mr. and Mrs. Brown. This is my wife, Mrs. Stevens. We were all at the fight last night.
Oh, yeah? You recognize me in person?
Not when you're standing up. Oh, it's you, all right.
Let's get started.
Oh, yes. What's this all about, Mr. Commissioner?
Well, nothing serious, Mr. Fenton. I just want to have a little chat about last night's fight.
Fight? Well, we had a little bad luck last night, you know. Dynamite didn't see Bobo's left coming.
Well, I couldn't see it. He had his right stuck in my eye.
Oh, you don't think there was anything wrong with the fight, do you, Mr. Commissioner?
Well, frankly, yes, but you don't have anything to be worried about yet, Mr. Fenton. You see, I'm completely objective and unbiased.
That's right.
Disinterested and unprejudiced.
That's right.
This inquiry will be fair and impartial.
All we want to do is find out why you dirty crooks threw the fight.
Sure. Oh, so that's it. Your wife thinks my boy took a dive.
It was sort of a running half gainer into a double jackknife and a swan. For a minute, I thought he was Esther Williams.
Well, just look at that boy. Young, clean cut, honest as the day is long. Why, this youngster has too much personal pride in his profession to do anything illegal or underhanded. He's too ambitious, too anxious to make good. Why, look at him as he stands before you, the perfect example of young American youth, clean-eyed, clear-eyed, young, clean cut, honest as the day is long. Why, this youngster has too much personal pride in his profession to do anything illegal or underhanded. Now, it must be obvious that last night's fight was not a double cross. Honest, he's very honest.
Hi, Judge Stevens.
Oh, Rutledge. Oh, Rutledge, I want you to meet Mr. and Mrs. Brown.
How are you?
Oh, Soapy and Dynamite here.
Of course. How are you, boys?
Rutledge of the Daily Enterprise.
I got a tip you were talking to Dynamite Tucker, and my editor thought our readers might be interested.
I'm getting more interested myself.
Now, look, Mr. Commissioner, That go was strictly on the up and up. Believe me, you saw the way Bobo belted my boy.
I saw the punch, and it couldn't have knocked out a midget.
This is my wife, Mrs. Stevens.
How do you do, Mrs. Stevens?
It wasn't one punch, it was a combination.
Yeah, he's right, Johnny. Now, here's exactly what happened. The two fighters were squaring off in the center of the ring. All of a sudden, Dynamite painted with his left. Then Bobo painted with his left. Then he crossed with his right.
Dynamite.
Gee,
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hit him so hard.
Oh, boy, isn't this something. Last night, this bum gets belted out by another bum, and today he gets belted out by a rank amateur.
Who's the bum? I'll show you who's the bum. Let me at the...
Excuse me.
I got to run. I got to meet someone uptown in 5 minutes.
Who?
Me. Come on.
Oh, boy, have we seen a sight. Why, the people in this town would pay thousands to see what we just saw.
They what?
Don Tootin'. Amateur versus pro. Why, it'd be a bigger drawing card than any regular match we've ever had.
Then they'll get a chance to see it for charity.
What?
You see, I'm on the Charity Bazaar Committee with Mrs. Carlisle Winthrop. And the attraction this year is going to be a match, or rather a rematch, between Dynamite Tucker and Wallopin' Wally.
How do you feel about it, Dynamite?
That little palooka?
He's a sissy. I'll knock him out in 7-8 rounds.
Well, is it a deal?
Oh, sure. We want to show the public this guy's a great fighter. Come on, you bum. You're going to start training. You got more law than you than street fights.
Joan, I don't know what you could have been thinking of to even suggest that my Wally get into the ring with that professional fighter.
Hello, Sally.
Hello. You'll just have to call the paper and tell them it's all off. The charity will have to raise money some other way.
Oh, Sally, you can't do this to us. I promised Penelope Winthrop, and it means so much to her.
Then let her husband fight Dynamite Tucker.
Oh, that wouldn't be any good. Nobody wants to see old man Winthrop get beaten up. Wally, everybody wants to see.
Oh, well, they won't. They just won't. I won't let them.
Hello, Joan. Hello, baby. You gotta watch yourself in the clinches, baby. As soon as I get your message, you come right over, baby. What's the trouble, baby?
Look out, Wally. Okay, that's the end of the round, Wally. Go to your corners.
Oh, Wally, darling, did you read that story in the paper about you fighting Dynamite Tucker?
Did I read it? Everybody in town read it. And I found out something. A guy with a terrific right-hand punch in this town gets a lot of respect.
Well, Wally, you've got a terrific right-hand punch. Boy. Just look at that muscle on you. Huh?
Oh.
You know, if you had started out to be a prize fighter, Wally, why, you could have been another Jack Dempsey. Owned your own restaurant and everything.
Oh, me? Yeah. You know, the boys down at the office are all comparing me to Rocky Marciano. But I think you got the right idea, Joni. I'm more like Dempsey or Tunney.
You know,
today, Chet Morris down at the office paid me back the $20 he's owed me for 3 years. And the boss even come out. Help him. And I want to test.
End of round two.
Well, the funniest thing happened at the cafeteria at lunch today.
Yeah, what happened,
Mom? Some wise guy came in and took my regular table. You should have heard him apologize when I told him who I was.
Well, it's a good thing it didn't happen tomorrow.
What do you mean?
Well, I bet this wise guy wouldn't be so anxious to apologize after he read in the paper how you backed out of the fight with Dynamite.
Backed out? Who's backing out? I never backed out of a fight, Mike. All right. Oh, I forgot to tell you. I won't be able to make it home for dinner tonight.
Why not?
Well, I'm going to address some Boy Scouts on the manly art of self-defense. But I won't be out late, baby. Now, sir, come on, Johnny. Come on, baby.
Hey, sir. I'll
get him. Bye, killer. Keep your chin down.
Where do I get this guy in the ring tonight? I'll fracture him.
I heard that before. I think I'll go out and count the house. You keep dancing, it'll improve your footwork.
Dancing, that's all you make me do. Who am I going to fight, Dr. Murray?
You sack the gut and prove your dancing so you can keep that cut glass chin out of the way. Now get going.
Well, I'll kill him.
Dancing.
The commissioner's wife. What are you doing here?
Now, don't blow your top, Dynamite. I just want to talk to you.
Well, you better wait until Soapy gets back. He manages my talking, too.
Well, at least you can listen to me. You know, Dynamite, I can tell just by looking at you that you are a gentleman.
Wait a minute. I'll put me robe on.
Dynamite, I want you to do me a favor. Funny you're fighting tonight. Wally Brown happens to be a very close friend of mine and the commissioner's. And we want you to take it easy on him.
Oh, he'll be easy, all right. I'll knock him out in 8 rounds.
No, you can't do that.
All right, then. 9 rounds at the most.
No, you don't understand. You see, this fellow isn't a fighter. He's not in condition. Or you might kill him. And then they send you to jail for manslaughter. Now, you wouldn't want that to happen, would you?
No. But I can't throw a fight without talking with my manager. He handles that department, too, and I don't want to butt into his end of the business.
Oh, yeah, but this isn't a real fight. It's just an exhibition for charity. Dynamite, I'm going to appeal to your better side. This fellow you're fighting is a newlywed, and his wife is home right now crying her eyes out for fear that he'll get hurt.
Oh, the poor kid.
She thinks that you're a mean, tough, vicious killer.
Gee, she really thinks I'm that good, huh?
Well, of course she does. That's why you got her so worried that he might get hurt. Now, what do you say? Will you promise me that you won't hurt him?
Well, all right. I'll carry the poor bum. But you can tell his wife it's because of her and the nice things she said about me.
I will, and thanks, Dynamite. You know something? I think you're a mean, tough, vicious killer, too.
You should be in the ring as Wally's second, and it's undignified. After all, you are the wife of a judge.
Well, Brad, I'm sorry, dear, but I gotta stick with Wally all the way. I can't take a chance on his losing his nerve at the last minute. Now, Sally, don't worry about a thing. I spoke to Dynamite. He gave me his word. Everything's going to be fine.
Hi, Joe. Hi, Tommy. Bill. There it is, boy.
Well, get it off. You'll melt the ice.
Sadie, it's cold in here.
Push it out, Paul. Ladies and gentlemen.
Louder.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Louder.
Ladies and gentlemen. The feature attraction on tonight's card, a rematch for charity.
Introducing that great local favorite, a man who has a record of 26 knockouts in 27 bouts.
And for a man who's been knocked out 26 times, he's in wonderful condition, girl.
The one, the only, Dynamite Tucker! Tipping the scales at 210, who, although not a professional boxer, has the distinguished record of once having beaten the great Sugar Ray Robinson. Correction, ladies and gentlemen. That Sugar Child Robinson.
That fellow plays the piano.
Here he is. Walloping Wally! Refereeing tonight's match, none other than Mushy Callahan.
Hi, boys. Okay, boys, you can take it away now.
What rule? Do you mean like the golden rule? Like, George Washington, that's what I
used to do.
All right, boys, shake hands. Shake hands now when the bell rings, come out, fight. Let's go.
Okay, Wally. Now listen. All you have to do is watch out for his right and watch out for his left. Then you got nothing to worry about. Two things.
I guess not.
Hey, what's the idea of that?
I'm taking my wife out to dinner right after the fight.
Get this out.
Lady, please leave the ring.
That's good. In the stomach, Wally. Have a chin. Stop him, Wally. Okay, Wally. On the chin. Oh, you've got him all the way. Hit him again, Wally. You got him. You got him. Grab him, Wally. It's going down. It's going down, Wally. He's going down. He's almost down. He should be down. Come on, boy.
Yeah, that's it. I'm killing him, ain't I?
Now, just a little iodine. Good, you'll love this.
The whole throat. Yeah. He'll fit you up, though. Well,
he's
in the ear.
Tired,
in the ear.
Whoa!
Come on, don't worry about a thing. Oh, got, oh this is the... Oh, no. All right, open the mouth. Say, ah, ah. Oh, geez, you're real sick, Wally. Yeah, I know. Just fix up the eye. Right?
Yeah. I know that.
Just fix the nose up there. There he is, right over there.
Over here.
I don't dare go there. Watch him. Get up, boy, Wally. Just feel him out. That's it, Wally. That's it. Hang on. Break him up, Wally.
Hey, wait a minute. Keep two thoughts of fighting.
Wally. Here we go, Wally.
I'd like to leave a call for 7, please.
My boy.
Winner!
You dirty double-crosser!
Can't help it, lady.
Brad, I gave Sally my word that dynamite wouldn't hurt Wally. I'll bet she never speaks to me again.
Well, it'll wear off in a little while. I talked to the doctor, and he said Wally isn't hurt too badly, and they'll be taking the bandages off the jaw in a couple of weeks.
I hear he's taking all his meals through a straw. I don't blame Sally for being mad at me. Sally!
Hi, Joan.
Hello, Sally.
Hello, Brad.
Hello, Sally.
Hello, Sally! See, I was afraid you'd never speak to me again.
Oh, Joan. You know, in a way, it was all a blessing in disguise. After Wally accidentally knocked out dynamite in Brad's office, he became so arrogant he was unbearable. Swaggering, boasting, bragging all over the place. Now he's his old sweet self again.
Well, what do you know?
And the liquid diet that he's on is the best thing that could have happened. The doctor's been trying to get him to take off weight for months. Oh, well, I gotta go down to the market, get some fruit juices for his dinner. I'll talk to you later.
Okay, goodbye, Sally.
Bye.
Well, you see, dear, everything worked out for the best. But what I can't figure out is how a little girl like you knocked out a great big lug like dynamite.
Well, I don't know either, Brad. All I did was, ooh, you dirty double-crosser.
Juices for Brad, too.
I'm Mary Jones. What a girl, what a world, what a life. Oh, I'm Mary Jones. What a mind, love is blind, what a wife. Ooh, giddy and gay all day, she keeps my heart laughing.